Hello everyone, we will see today Primavera project management software. So I just opening the project management software that Primavera P6 that I am using P6 professional 18 version, and you need to give the password that you have input before when you are installing and then connect. So I am using Primavera P6. So it will be like coming by default activities. So activity window, it is coming because before I just closing, I was working in this project, and that's why it is like by default, it is coming in activity. Now we will see one by one. Like first we will see enterprise project structure. For that, first you need to understand what you mean by enterprise project structure. For that, you need to go to enterprise and then enterprise project structure. So it is something like a hierarchical structure that identifies the company-wide projects and enable organizing and management of those projects. For example, this enterprise, you know, having a engineering and construction division, energy division, manufacturing division, and also they have product development, corporate, IT, everything. So it's something like a company-wide projects, and it is like having hierarchy. So that is called enterprise project structures. These EPS can be created, you know, for up to 50 levels. Maximum character length for this ID, EPS ID, you can go for 20. And the EPS description, for example, now it is like EPS name. If you are clicking this, you can able to see EPS ID, EPS name and everything. And even you can go for description. So that description should be 100. So now we will see how to create a new EPS. For that, I'm just taking add button. Once you add button, so it will be coming under previous EPS. You need to use this arrow to move it further down so that you will be having separate EPS. So this is separate. And now we created another one that is separate. So that also it is inside actually new EPS. You can use this arrow to even more come out of the structure. So now we created this one. You can just double click here and you can specify like CCL. For example, just ID that I am putting, construction chemicals. And even you can go for EPS name or describe what it is, construction chemicals limited. So something like that you can create. And in that, if you want furthermore, you can go for, and even you can use here, for example, MP, and then, so it must be unique name actually. So already this EPS structure having MP, look, I am just putting MA, and EPS name should be manufacturing limited. And later you can choose for responsible manager also from here, that we will discuss later, that in OBS. Now I'm just again going to add another EPS ID, process PR, process plant. So like this, you can add multiple divisions in your hierarchy for your organization. So just now we created this CCL, construction chemicals limited, or construction company, or whatever you can name it, and you can describe it here. And this is having unique ID. it should be unique. So in this is like level 1. Level 2, we have 2, process plant and manufacturing limited. Now if you want to delete something, you can just select and then delete, but I don't want to delete, I want to have everything. Now you can go for a display chart view. When you are going for a chart view, you can able to see the things clearly. You can make it bigger. So now we created Construction Chemicals Limited. This is an enterprise having further 2 more levels, like a further level. In that level we have two things, that is one is process plant and another one is manufacturing limited. So 2 divisions we can say in one enterprise. Further these can go for further divisions as well. So if you want to go back to the previous view, you can click the table view again. It will be like this. And here we also have some options. So for example, if you have multiple EPS, you can use find and you can search directly. For example, process. And then you can go for find next. There is no match. And otherwise I can go for neo. And then I'm just putting find next. It is not finding. So I will put Neotech and then find next. Here we have match old word only or match case. In that case, I will put match old word only and then find next. No matches are found. See, now we have enterprise CCL and then these things, you know, like now I am just going for find and then I am putting construction. And I am just putting find next, no mer matches found. Otherwise you can put the EPS ID here. For example, I am putting CCL and then I'm putting find next. So it is considering only the EPS ID. It is not considering the EPS name. So you should be aware of it. And if you are putting NL and then find next, it will be showing you the EPS. So you should remember the EPS ID. Again, it is another drawback. So if you want to find something based on EPS name, then it is difficult. You can't able to find in this program. For example, if you want to put only the match case also, it won't consider. See, it is telling no matches found, because in that case you need to put, if I'm putting CCL and then I'm putting find next, it is not showing. So you need to put CCL in caps and then you need to put find next. That is for match case. And if you want to put match whole word only, or then if I'm putting see, it won't show anything. Yeah, still it is showing because it is like a match whole word only. So C is there, so it will show. If I am putting directly C and then find next, it won't. It will show by one by one. See, here we have C, and again here also we have C, you know, manufacturing C also there. So you should put the whole word. In that case, it won't show you anything. Still it is showing, but it is having C, but nothing else. Still it is showing match whole word only. So you can use it. If I am putting LO and then I am searching, so name, no matches found. So you need to put LOB and then 1, and I am putting find next, it is not showing. Now I am putting LOB 1 and then I am putting find next, it is not showing because here there is one space in between. So you need to put space and then find next, it will find. If you are just taking and then I am just putting LO, see, it is just finding. So that is what match whole word only. It will be considered only if you are inputting the whole word, even the spaces as well. For example, if you want to go for a this one. So you need to type prod, and then you can go for find next. It is like going there. But if you want to put only the whole word, you can go for prod proc and then 2, it will exactly go to that EPS ID. So this is something like a find option, nothing else. So I'm just canceling it. Here you also have find next option. So we already seen inside find itself. See, this is like find next, and also they have another option for find next, and even you can go for print preview. So if you want to print preview, then I'm just going for a print preview. See, this is what we will be having. Then you can able to go for page setup and you can change everything you want. Now I'm just closing it. This we will discuss later. Now I'm just going for chart view. If you want to print it, you can go for print preview. See, can you able to see that? So this could be helpful for you if you are having organization in that you have multiple divisions, in this divisions like multiple subdivisions, and in multiple subdivisions multiple workers working. So all can, or multiple projects you have, you should not tell multiple workers, you should say in this division we will be having multiple projects. So you all this you can able to like put in this kind of view, and you can able to take printout. So I'm just closing it. See, in this also we can able to do lots of detail works. For example, if I'm putting detail, if I'm checking, unchecking details, it is going. If I'm checking again, it will come. And another thing you can able to go for. See, there is something called a chart box template. Even you can go for customize. Even chart font and colors you can customize. For example, if I want some other font, for example, if I'm just selecting this option, I'm just going for narrow bold, and I'm just putting OK. And once you apply it, it will change. And if I'm just changing the background color, for example, background color, we can have a black if you want, or I am just taking this color, or I can go for green, and I'm just clicking OK and apply. So this is like a background color. So before it is white, now I did green color. Now I can go for box color also. If I'm just going for box color, I'm just taking this pink one and then select and then apply. So now we have customized this to whatever the colors we want. I'm just closing it. You need to put OK. Now we also have shortcut template. Now you can go for customizing it. So that one you can right click from here, or you can go from here. So here you have WBS code, CCL, WBS name, Construction Chemicals Limited, and then responsible manager. So I didn't assign, so that's why it is not showing. Otherwise here, construction company, I have assigned one name. Okay, I have assigned that name to the previous project that I did in Primavera. So that's why here it is showing responsible manager as Hariprasad. So I just did for sample project, nothing more. So here we can able to change the WBS code. And even you can change the height also. If you want to change the height to 2, and you can able to see how it looks. See, now it is like having height of 2. Otherwise, no need, 1 is enough. And you can't go back, 1 minimum value should be 1. Okay. Now these things you can able to do, and the total width also you can able to change. For example, if I'm putting 100. So I'm just applying it. So can you able to see the difference? So it depends on the thing that you require. So we can customize everything. Now I can go for, if you want a responsible manager to be on top, you can go for shifting up. And then if you want to apply, you can apply. So responsible managers come on top on all EPS that we have. So if you want to add something, you can add. For example, if I'm adding something, so it will be showing you the drop down. If you want to add actual cost, you can add the actual cost here and you can apply. So it will show you the actual cost of the projects as well. So I just now like created one project, so I didn't assume any resources so that the project cost is showing as zero. Otherwise the project is not started and not updated. If it is not started and updated, so the project cost will be zero only. So like this you can able to customize. If you don't want, you can just delete also. For example, if I don't want actual cost, I can delete it, and then you need to put apply. So like this you can able to go for. There is no undo option in this software. If you want to add something, you can add from here. For example, estimated cost. Or if you want to show something else, you can take from here. So for example, current data date, something like that, and then you can go for apply. There is no data date. So like this it will be. So you can customize all those things. For example, if you want some other like actual duration or actual cost, this is like something like EPS. In this, whatever you want, you can put anticipated start. I am putting and then applying it. So it is not showing anything because we don't have any values over there. So like this you can able to go for. Otherwise you can just type W and it will show you the W things, WBS things. And if you want to show the WBS path or website root directory, WBS category, I am putting category and then I am just putting apply. So if you have those details, it will be updated here. Okay, if I want default, you can just click default. If you want to shift down, you can go for WBS category to be shift down and then apply. So it is null because we don't assign any category for this EPS. After all, if you want to put default, you can just go for default and then apply. Now everything will go, but the colors remain same. So colors not going, otherwise everything will go to the previous default position. Now I'm just clicking OK. So these are all the options we do have in EPS. And we also have zoom, zoom in, and then zoom out. Otherwise you can go for zoom to best fit, that could be even more better. Zoom, zoom to best fit. So it will be like this. Otherwise you can go for zoom out. Otherwise you can hold control, and that doesn't work in the software. You can make the screen bigger. So in that case you can able to see everything. So normally this view I like most. And you can go for table view as well. So this is like a traditional view. Now we have completed creating an enterprise project structure, and we also seen customizations in it. So we will see one by one in upcoming classes.